My title today is OPR, right? For those that you don't know what is the OPR, basically it's overnight policy rate, okay? So basically, bank, sometimes they need cash. They also need to borrow money from Bank Negara. So this OPR rate basically will be the interest that they are going to charge to the bank, right? So now basically that is a cost that they need to bear when they're doing the loan payment, right? So when the OPR is getting higher, so that means the bank also going to charge you a higher interest rate. So if a Bank Negara declare the lower OPR rate, that means overall the interest rate also going down to be lower. Now 1.75, which is in the year 2008, on the last 13 years ago, so at the point of time in year 2008, our OPR also I remember is higher than 1.75, which is, I can remember is 1.8 or 1.9, something like that, right? Since we hit into the COVID-19, since last year, maybe somewhere around September, October, I cannot remember exactly. So this 1.75 was applied into somewhere around September. So until now, we are still remaining at 1.75 into the OPR rate. Now, many people may think that 1.75, you know, continue going down. At before the COVID-19, we remain above 2, right? With this decline, would it be also impact on the overall bank revenue and profit, right? Because the interest is going to going down, right? Now, but you need to remember, yeah, although the loan interest is going down, at the same time, the fixed deposit or whatever interest rate they give it back to the customer, at the same time also lower down. Right now, the bank is working very simple way, right? You save the money, then bank use the money and borrow to another person, right? So at the same time, he will get the loan interest from the person that borrower, and then he will pay you back for you that you save into my deposit into my bank and give you back the interest, right? So that is a concept, right? Basic concept that you understand. So at the end of the day, even though the interest is going down, they loan the money going down, at the same time they also pay you back low interest fixed deposit or whatever, right? So that is not a very huge impact. That is could be only a minor impact on the bank revenue and profit itself, right? Even though the OPR is going to reduce now, but with today on the situation is global economy situation, which is the COVID hits into Malaysia. And not only happened in Malaysia, but in fact, the whole global, right, including other countries, US and Japan, the whole world is doing the same thing. And all their country also reducing on their OPR rate, right? All the banks in the world, right? So, but this is the challenge in the sense that when bank adjusted on the OPR, it doesn't impact. But the problem is what is going to impact on the bank, right? So the chances are people don't have a job. Business closing down, that is how the people going to repay the loan, right? So which is, we consider it is a expected credit loss.